Hello students, today we will learn about Kirchhoff's laws. Today we will study about Kirchhoff's laws. So there are two types of laws, or there are two laws, Kirchhoff's current law and Kirchhoff's voltage law, that is KCL and KVL. So what is the statement of Kirchhoff's current law? The statement is, the algebraic sum of currents at any junction, the algebraic sum of currents at any junction or node is always equal to zero. The algebraic sum of currents at any junction or node, algebraic sum of currents at any junction, this is a junction point or node. So algebraic sum of currents at any junction or node is always equal to zero. That is, summation I is equal to zero. Summation I is equal to zero. Here, let current I1 and I2, these currents are coming towards the junction or towards the node, and currents I3 and I4, these currents are leaving from the junction. So the sum of currents entering towards the junction is always equal to sum of currents leaving from the junction. So here in this figure, currents I1 and I2, these are incoming currents, or these currents are entering towards the junction, and I3 and I4, these currents are leaving from the junction. So sum of currents entering the junction is always equal to sum of currents leaving from the junction. So here I1 plus I2, sum is I1 plus I2 is equal to I3 plus I4. Therefore, I1 plus I2 minus I3 minus I4 is equal to 0. Okay, I1 plus I2 minus I3 minus I4 is equal to 0. That is, summation I is equal to 0. Okay, so this is the Kirchhoff's current law. Algebraic sum of currents at any junction or node is always equal to 0. Now, what is the Kirchhoff's voltage law, KVL? So, Kirchhoff's voltage law, the statement of Kirchhoff's voltage law or KVL is, the algebraic sum of voltages around any closed circuit or closed loop is always equal to zero. That is, summation V is equal to zero. See here in figure C, in this figure, resistors R1, R2, R3 are connected in series across a battery V. Okay, so this is a closed circuit or closed loop. So sum of the algebraic sum of EMFs or algebraic sum of voltages around this closed circuit is always equal to zero. That is, V minus V1 minus V2 minus V3 is equal to zero, or V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3, where V1 is the voltage across R1, V2 is the voltage across R2, and V3 is the voltage across R3. Okay, V1 is the voltage which drops across R1, V2 is the voltage which drops across R2, and V3 is the voltage which drops across R3. So V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3, or V minus V1 minus V2 minus V3 is equal to zero. So this is called as Kirchhoff's voltage law. Okay, now see the one example here. Now there are two figures. In figure A, resistors R1 and R2 are connected in parallel. So it's we have to find out the total resistance or its equivalent resistance. So we know that in parallel circuit, the total resistance is 1 upon RT is equal to total resistance is 1 upon RP is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2. So here R1 is 12 kilo ohm, R2 is also 12 kilo ohm. So 1 upon RT is equal to 1 upon 12K plus 1 upon 12K. That is equal to 2 upon 12K. This is 1 upon RT. Now we have to find out total resistance RT. So RT is equal to 12K divided by 2. 12K divided by 2, that is equal to 6 kilo ohm. Okay. So here its effective resistance or its total resistance is 6 kilo ohm. R1 and R2 are connected in parallel. So 12K parallel 12K is equal to 6 kilo ohm. Okay. Or there is another formula to find out total resistance. RT is equal to R1 into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Here R1 is 12K, R2 is also 12K. So 12K into 12K divided by 12K plus 12K. That is equal to 12K into 12K divided by 24K. Okay. KK will cancel. Then its RT is equal to 6 kilo ohm. Okay. KK will cancel. 12 ke 12, 12 duni 24, be kabe, be sak 12. Okay, 6 kilo ohm. Okay, RT is equal to 6 kilo ohm. Now, find current through resistor R1, that is I1. Current through resistor R1, that is I1. So, I1 is equal to V upon R1. So, V means voltage across R1, it is 12 volt. Okay, so V is 12 volt and R1 is 12 kilo ohm. So, I1 is equal to V upon R1. Okay, so I1 is equal to 12 volt, V means 12 volt divided by R1, that is 12K. Okay, so 12 volt divided by 12K. K means 10 raised to plus 3. K means kilo ohm. K means kilo ohms. K means kilo ohm. So K is equal to 10 raised to plus 3. So 12 volt divided by 12 into 10 raised to plus 3. Okay. So 12 will cancel. So 1 into 10 raised to minus 3. This current is in ampere. Now convert it into milliampere. So multiply this figure again by 10 raised to plus 3. Then current will be in milliampere. So 1 into 10 raised to 0. That is 1 into 1. That is 1 milliampere. So I1 is equal to 1 milliampere. Okay. Now find I2. So here I2 is equal to V upon R2. So V is 12 volt and R2 is again 12 kilo ohm. So I2 is equal to 12 volt divided by 12K. That is 12 divided by 12 into 10 raised to plus 3. K means 10 raised to plus 3. So 12 into 10 raised to plus 3. 12 cancel. So 1 into 10 raised to minus 3 ampere, and that is 1 milliampere, because when this current is in ampere, so we have to convert it into milliampere. So multiply this by 10 raised to plus 3, then current will convert into milliampere. Okay, so 1 into 10 raised to minus 3 into 10 raised to plus 3, that is 10 raised to 0, that is 1. So 1 into 1, 1 milliampere. So I2 is again 1 milliampere. Now total current IT or I is equal to I1 plus I2. Here current is divided. So I is equal to I1 plus I2. Total current I is equal to I1 plus I2. That is 1 milliampere plus 1 milliampere is equal to 2 milliampere. So total current I is 2 milliampere. Okay. Again, this total current I can be calculated by using the formula V is equal to I is equal to V upon RT. V upon RT, where RT is the total resistance. Okay, so that is equal to 12 volt. 12 volt. V is 12 volt. So 12 divided by RT. RT is 6 kilo ohm. Okay, so V upon RT, that is equal to 12 divided by 6K is equal to 12 divided by 6 into 10 raised to 3. K is equal to 10 raised to 3. Okay. K means kilo ohm. So 12 divided by 6 into 10 raised to 3. 6 kilo ohm. 6 kilo ohm cha ohm madhe convert karayacha. 6 kilo ohm hai. Tije ohm kiti hona? 6 into 10 raised to 3 ohms. Okay. K means 10 raised to 3. Okay. So 6 ke 6 sayudani 12. 2 into 10 raised to minus 3 ampere. Okay. Convert it into milliampere. So 2 into 10 raised to minus 3 into 10 raised to plus 3. Then current will be in milliampere. So it is 2 milliampere. Okay. So I is equal to 2 milliampere. Here also I is equal to I1 plus I2. 1 plus 1, 2 milliampere. Okay. So this is total current I. Now see circuit B. Consider circuit B. This is circuit B. Here resistors 12 kilo ohm and 6 kilo ohm are connected in parallel. Then its total resistance RT, that is 1 upon RT is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2. That is 1 upon 12K plus 1 upon 6K. Okay. 1 upon 12K plus 1 upon 6K. Okay. So that is 1 plus 2 divided by 12K. That's all. So 1 plus 2 divided by 12K. Now this is, that is 3 upon 12K. This is 1 upon RT is equal to 3 upon 12K. So RT is equal to 12K divided by 3. RT is equal to 12K divided by 3. That is equal to 4 kilo ohm. So total resistance is 4 kilo ohm. Or RT is equal to R1 into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. That is 12K into 6K divided by 12K plus 6K. So that is equal to 12K into 6K divided by 18K. Okay. So 72K divided by 18. 1 kilo ohm, 1K will cancel here. So 72K divided by 18, that is equal to 4 kilo ohm. Okay, this is the total resistance RT. Okay. Now we have to find out I1. So I1 is equal to V upon R1. So V upon R1, here V is a 12 volt. So 12 divided by 12K, that is equal to 12 cancel, 1 into 10 raised to minus 3 ampere. Here K means 10 raised to plus 3, it works at 10 raised to minus 3. Yeah, 1 into 10 raised to minus 3 ampere. And again, we multiply it by 10 raised to plus 3. So current will be in milliampere. So that current will come in milliampere. So that is 1 milliampere. Again, I2 is equal to V upon R2. So V is 12 volt and R2 is 6K. 12 volt divided by 6K. That is I2. I is equal to V upon R. I is equal to V upon R. So V is 12 volt and R means 6 kilo ohm. Okay. So I2 is equal to 12 volt divided by 6K. 12 volt divided by 6. 12 volt divided by 6K. That is 2 into 10 raised to minus 3 ampere. Here 10 raised to plus 3. Ever zatil 10 raised to minus 3 will. Sai ke sa sayudani 12. 2 into 10 raised to minus 3 ampere. That is 2 milliampere. So I is equal to I1 plus I2. I1 is 1 milliampere. I2 is 2 milliampere. So 1 plus 2, 3 milliampere. Okay. Total current I is 3 milliampere. Okay. Again, we can calculate I using the formula I is equal to V upon RT. RT is the total resistance. Okay. And RT is 4 kilo ohm. Okay. And V means 12 volt. So 12 divided by 4 kilo ohm. That is equal to 3 into 10 raised to minus 3 ampere. A kilo ohm var jatil 10 raised to minus 3 only. 10 raised to plus 3 var gele or 10 raised to minus 3 will. 4 trik 12. 3 into 10 raised to minus 3 ampere. So 3 into 10 raised to minus 3 into 10 raised to plus 3. Then current will be in milliampere. Okay. So 3 into 10 raised to 0. That is 3 into 1. that is I is equal to 3 milliampere. I is equal to 3 milliampere. So here I is equal to I1 plus I2. Therefore, I minus I1 minus I2 is equal to 0. So current I is 3 milliampere. I1 is 1 milliampere. I1 is 1 milliampere. And I2 is 2 milliampere. So 3 minus 1 minus 2, that is 3 minus 3 is equal to 0. Therefore, summation I is equal to 0. Algebraic sum is 0. Algebraic sum of currents at any junction or node is always equal to 0. So this is called as Kirchhoff's current law, KCL. In this way, KCL can be verified. Now we have to verify Kirchhoff's voltage law, that is algebraic sum of voltages around any closed loop is always equal to 0, that is summation V is equal to 0. So here V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. R1, R2, R3, these resistors are connected in series. So here first of all we have to find out current through the circuit. Current through this circuit, that is I is equal to current in the series circuit remains same. So I is equal to V upon R1 plus R2 plus R3. I is equal to V upon R1 plus R2 plus R3. This will be current. So see here. So see here, R1, R2 and R3, these three resistors are connected in series. R1, R2 and R3 are connected in series. So its total resistance is RT is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. Let R1 is equal to 1 kilo ohm, R2 is equal to 2 kilo ohm and R3 is equal to 1 kilo ohm. And V is equal to 12 volt. Then RT is equal to 1 plus 2 plus 2, 1 plus 2 plus 1, that is 4 kilo ohm. RT is equal to 4 kilo ohm. Total resistance RT is equal to 4 kilo ohm. Now current I through this circuit is equal to I is equal to V upon R. So here I is equal to V upon total resistance, okay, that is R1 plus R2 plus R3, okay. So I is equal to, here V is a 12 volt divided by RT 4 kilo ohm, okay. So I is equal to V upon R1 plus R2 plus R3, that is total resistance, because in series circuit resistors are total resistance, okay. There is sum of resistors is when resistors are connected in series, then RT is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3, okay. So I is equal to V upon total resistance. So I is equal to 12 volt divided by 4 kilo ohm, 1 plus 2 plus 1, that is 4 kilo ohm. So I is equal to 12 divided by 4 kilo ohm, that is 12 divided by 4 into 10 raised to 3 ohm, okay. 4 ke 4, 4 3, 12, 3 into 10 raised to minus 3 ampere, that is equal to 3 into 10 raised to minus 3, again into 10 raised to plus 3, then current will be milliampere. So 3 into 1, 10 raised to 10 raised to 0, so that is 1, 3 into 1, that is equal to 3 milliampere. So I is equal to 3 milliampere. Okay. This is the current flowing through this circuit I. Okay. I is equal to 3 milliampere. Then V1 is the voltage drop across R1. So V1 is equal to I into R1. V1 is equal to I into R1. So I is 3 milliampere, means 3 into 10 raised to minus 3 ampere. So 3 into 10 raised to minus 3, this current is in now in ampere. So 3 into 10 raised to minus 3 into R1, 1 kilo ohm means 1 into 10 raised to plus 3 ohm. Kilo ohm cha ohm madhe convert kara, hai na? 1 kilo ohm hai, tyache ohm kartana 10 raised to plus 3 ni multiply karaycha. So 1 into 10 raised to plus 3, okay, ohm. So that is equal to 3 into 10 raised to 0 means 3 into 1 means 3 volt. So then V2 is equal to I into R2, that is now I is 3 milliampere, that is 3 into 10 raised to minus 3 ampere into R2 is 2 kilo ohm, okay, so 2 into 10 raised to 3 ohm, 2 kilo ohm so ohm kara, means 2 into 10 raised to plus 3 ohm, so 3 into 2, 6, 6 into 10 raised to 0 means 1, so 6 into 1, 6 volt. So V2 is 6 volt. Then V3, that is I into R3, I is 3 milliampere, so that is 3 into 10 raised to minus 3 ampere, a milliampere sa ampere madhe kelele, and into R3 is 1 kilo ohm, that is 1 into 10 raised to plus 3 ohm. Okay, so 10 raised to 3 and 10 raised to minus 3, that is 10 raised to 0 means 1, and 1 into 3, that is 3 volt. Okay, now V is equal to applied voltage, V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. Okay, so 3 volt plus 6 volt plus 3 volt, that is equal to 12 volt. Okay, and applied battery voltage is also 12 volt. So V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3, that is V is 12 volt minus 3 volt minus 6 volt minus 3 volt is equal to 0, because V1 is 3 volt, okay, V2 is 6 volt and V3 is 3 volt. So 12, V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3, so V minus V1 minus V2 minus V3 is equal to 0. So 12 minus 3 minus 6 minus 3 is equal to 0. So 12 minus 12. 3 and 7, 9, 19, 12. So 12 minus 12, that is 0. So summation V is equal to 0. That is algebraic sum of voltages around around any closed loop or around any closed circuit is always equal to 0. Or summation V is equal to 0. So this is called as Kirchhoff's voltage law. Okay, so in this way Kirchhoff's voltage law can be verified. We will stop here.